that disciple Frank Lloyd Wright made them that model, and I remember my wife and I visiting them. They lived in Sausalito, a marvelous place just outside San Francisco, and he had it actually covered with a cloth, and he sort of dramatically opened that. And first of all, I just looked at it, and I had this intuitive feeling it was all wrong, and I couldn't put my finger completely on it. I sort of looked at my wife, and well, all wrong as the roof was removed. And in desperation, I said, but where would I put pictures? And he said, ah, there's a place right here where you can, and he showed me then a design, where you can lean a picture right there. He said, a picture. And I said, yes, and? He said, well, then you remove it and you put another one there. Well, you know, I mean, I really realized we were just not communicating on the same wavelength, and extricated ourselves from that here. And that's when I felt that architecture to live with us, because you have to understand it's going to be my house, our house. And that is just to find out how we live. And we were, once we wanted to have privacy for everyone in the house. So that was essential. We wanted to have a large living room, not broken up, and didn't even want to have a dining room. So we ended up with a 40-foot-long living room, you know, which is substantial. And there was plenty of space for pictures and books and stuff like that, yeah. And same thing with the children's rooms and study. And it worked beautifully. So then he got a very good builder. And so that was probably January of the year in which we wanted to move, on September, let's say the 6th or 8th, something like that, early September. So we said, we want to move into that house when we arrive. So on September 6th, let's say, that house has to be finished so that when we arrive from the airport, we can sleep there. And we ordered some bed. Most of the furniture was going to be, some was going to be shipped, but most of it was going to be new furniture anyway. And so we ordered beds so they would be available. And finally, we met the builder, which was a wonderful Finnish builder, very high quality. But we drew up this contract. I said, but you know, it's September 6th. And, yeah, okay. I said, but we are going to do what we do in Mexico. That is, there's a penalty clause. And you pay X dollars a day that you are late. And that was a significant sum. And, you know, by that time, the man was destroying and said, yeah, but, you know, how do I know? I said, well, but that's part of the thing. I'm willing to pay for this, but that's what it is. And I said, I'll make a quid pro quo. I pay you for every day you're early. So that, of course, had this real incentive. But it turned out that, in fact, they met exactly the deadline. And what was so amusing is that I, it shows again my why I'm a tough client to have. I had one thing I've always been interested in art in the places where I work, on walls and offices and things like this, and particularly in office structures, where there are frequently long gangways, and you know, you walk and you have everything is empty, there are just doors on the side. And if you had something to focus on at a distance, particularly if it's something artistic in one way or another, starting, then you focus on that, you don't see the doors behind you. The gangway becomes just a tunnel on where you focus on the light at the end of the tunnel. And there was such a corridor in that house. Bathroom doors, my study door came off, and that led to a bedroom door. And I said, what I would like you to do, that bedroom door, I would like you to convert the entire bedroom door, and I sent him the design, into a Mondrian painting, which was not a painting. Either you could, yeah, a Mondrian, and after any painter, house painter, can of course copy a Mondrian. It's not a Mondrian, but the design is there. And the Mondrian design worked quite well for that, to focus on the even from the distance, because you don't have to see any real details there. The architect loved this, but said, okay, I'll modify it. We'll make it really out of very high quality plastic rather than painted it. Now that was more complicated, I said, fine. So that was it. So there we arrive on the 6th of September, and the architect was so excited, he actually met us there, but we were gonna drive there and stay the first night. It's quite exciting to see your house. it was an experience for the builder that he couldn't believe, because we didn't show up there before. You see, usually people come all the time, they want to change things on. We said, look, we're gonna make all the detail. We pick right at the beginning the doorknobs, everything. So therefore, it's absolutely clear there will be no changes, because otherwise this is where the complication, of course, with deadline comes in. You always change it. All the decisions to the finest details were made at the beginning, which usually you don't, not in a residential house. And then I said, and the architect said, and he said, you're not going to come. I said, the architect is going to be responsible. So I don't want any excuses, and I want him to show up there every day, therefore, instead of thinking that we should catch any mistakes. Paid for that, but so he became a real supervising architect and couldn't just wash his hands of this. So and they all accepted that. So we were very peculiar clients. So there we arrived from Mexico City. The builder had essentially only had met us once. And there we arrived in his house, and everything was superb. But that door wasn't there. And that's the first thing I noticed. And I said, but listen, didn't I tell you about this door? And the man felt terrible, said the plastic had been quite delivered yet. The it was really very fancy formica, colored formica that had to be cut and arranged there. And I said, all right, I don't pay until we have that. It was a joke, of course, but until the door is in, the house is not completed. And that house was superb, and it was perhaps the most traumatic aspect of my eventual divorce, that my wife ended up with that house, but I ended up with an exquisite one on the ranch, so it was not, but that house always was just, it was really perfect. It's very rare that you have end up in a house that has everything that you want, and it hasn't changed. I mean, this house is now, it was built in 1960. This is 45 years later, and it is superb, unbelievably high quality and very well maintained.